The book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 6. I have said, ye are gods.
So this is Christ's words. He said, we are gods. To answer your question, we are gods. The Israelite man, which is the so-called Hispanic, African, the so-called African American, blacks, West Indians, and Hispanics on this song. Is your father on here? What's your father? Who's your father?
God.
He died?
He said,
Your father, your fleshly father.
Oh, Emma
Patterson. Is he a so-called African American? Would you call yourself black? So according to the Bible, you from the tribe of Judah right here.
That's right.
According to the prophecy, the same tribe that Jesus Christ came from. So back to your question, you said, are we gods? Go ahead.
Psalms chapter 82, verse 6. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
So God right here in the Bible reading, he said, we are gods. We're children of the Most High God, the Israelites. What the officer is bringing out, we're God's chosen people. We're special, better than everybody else on this earth. Go ahead.
But ye shall die like men.
But we're going to die like men. Why do you think we're dying like men? If God said he made you like Adam to be immortal, to live forever, but now you're dying, what do you think happened? It ain't hard, bro. I promise you, it's not a deep question. I'm going to give it to you. Sin. Because if you say you got a father. If your dad told you, be in the house at 9 o'clock, what happened if you ain't in the house at 9 o'clock? Exactly. We have to understand the Most High God is the same way. He's a black man according to the Bible. Christ,
right.
The Most High God, he created us in his own image. That goes with the way we carry ourselves. The reason we got swag about ourselves, why? Because we're like the Father in heaven. So just the same way when he tell us, if you don't do this, I'm going to do this. And if you don't do it, it happens to you.
I'm being chastened right now. Y'all know what chastened means?
Yeah. All of our people been chastised right now.
My last time, I just got out October 28th. It's the thing I got to do when I get out of line. When I get out of line, people was coming right here. I ain't supposed to be drinking. I ain't supposed to be going in. I'm in school right now. The vision he gave me. He gave me a vision.
Come on, Princess.
This run is corrupted, bro.
I'm with you 100%. Hey, hold it. Give me Revelation 18:4. You said 100%. The world is corrupt, especially when you look around, because in this society that we live in, right, they say it's okay for the black man to have multiple girlfriends, correct? What about you, sis? Is that a thing you see? You see men laying and having kids and leaving the woman by themselves? We out here to teach, sis. Don't we see that in our communities? A brother can have 5 baby mamas and he don't take care of none of them. Now, I'm not saying all brothers do that.
But I'm
leading to something. I'm saying, but don't we see that? Society says that's okay for you to do that. But the white man don't live like that.
Right.
The Chinese don't live like that.
Right.
The Arabs don't do that. It's just the black man.
Right.
The Hispanic man, they the ones with baby mama drama.
Right.
But we make music about it. We glory in that thing. We the only nation of people who glorify killing one another.
Right.
While the white man taking all your property, gentrifying everything, while they taking everything we leave after we kill each other, guess what they do? All right, well, cool. But since y'all gonna kill each other, on the background, I'm gonna take your kids for 8 hours a day, and I'm gonna brainwash them.
I'm gonna teach
your kids white man's religion and brainwash them while you out there in the club stripping.
Bring it up.
You know what I'm saying? While you out there popping dollars and popping tags. Guess what? That's the thing that they have set up for us. So to your point, yes, the world is corrupt, because that's why the Bible says this. Read this.
The book of Revelation, chapter 18, verse 4.
Bring it out.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people.
What did God say?
Come out of her, my people.
God told us to come out of her, Babylon, America's doctrines, America's philosophies. He said for us to come out of that. America teaches today man and man can marry each other.
Right.
A woman and woman can marry each other. Well, guess what? If a man marries a man and he's laying down with a man, and a woman is having sex with a woman, however they do that, where does the population grow?
Bring it up.
The black community does what? It stops.
Right.
It don't go. That's anti-life. You can't have a baby. A man and a man is not going to bring forth children. That's not going to bring forth our heritage.
Right.
Y'all understand that? The structure and everything is set up for a reason. A man is supposed to be guiding the household.
Right.
He's supposed to be over that woman to not only protect the woman, but guide her, instruct her, so she can instruct the children, so on and so forth. And today, to your, going back to your same point, the reason this world is corrupt because it doesn't uphold what the standards of God is. Today, they say you can smoke weed and get high all day. There's nothing wrong with drinking, but you're not supposed to be drunk. You feel me?
I'm gonna push you one more time.
Go ahead.
I just got into a serious argument about this the other night.
Go ahead.
It's a guy. or you God within. If you God within, why is it God?
The God, the Most High God created us in His image to rule this earth. That's why He made us. Let's get Sirach 17. Sirach 17 and verse. You started verse 1. Maybe this will help you out some more. All right. 17:1. Go ahead.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 17, verse 1.
So I'm going to show you God, there is a power, the Most High God. He created His Son and created us, right? I'm going to show you this.
The Lord created man of the earth and turned him into it again.
That's basically when it said turn it into again, meaning He made us from the dirt. When you die, you turn back to dirt. That's all it said. Go ahead.
He gave them few days in a short time and power also over the things therein.
Go ahead.
He endued them with strength by themselves and made them according to His image.
So God is telling you when He made this earth, of course, we already know the Father. The Father created us. He created this earth and He put us on the earth. But I'm going to show you why He made the earth for us. Why are we still walking around as men?
Verse 4.
And put the fear of man upon all flesh.
The what?
And upon the fear of man upon all flesh.
He's talking about the creations, whether it's bugs, animals, so on and so forth. He said they have the fear of man, which is us. Go ahead.
And gave him dominion.
What?
And gave him dominion over beasts and fowls.
The Most High God made the earth for you to rule. That's why He made us. That's why the scripture we read earlier, we are gods on this earth. God, that's why there is the God in heaven, and then we're down here. We're not in the heavens where He is, we're on the earth, because He made this earth for you. Everything in this thing, from the sun, moon, the stars, the grass, is for your benefit.
That's right.
You understand that? Even other nations, He made them. When I say the other nations, come on, all other nations outside of Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. He made them to serve you. That's their purpose. Does that answer your question? So let me ask you a question now. You said, go to Hosea 5 now. You said everything you do, you feel like you've been, was a, not afflicted, chastened. That's the word you use, right?
So my thing is,
remember that joke, opening his ears.
I've been revealed so much, God told me, I can't go back. I can't go against the rain.
Yeah, I'm going to show you right now some more.
I got a mission to heal this world from the sickness and weakness in this world. I've been through all this. It turned the pain. When you chastise, it's chastised.
Yes, sir. I'm gonna show you how the first step. Right now, you can take the first step of getting the wickedness out of here. All right, or setting that example. I'm gonna show you. Watch this. Let me see if you catch it.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So it's talking about an order that's set up, right? The head of man is Christ.
And the head of the woman is the man.
So the head of the woman is the man. You see how that's set up? It's a hierarchy.
And the head of Christ is God.
The head of Christ is God. So you have God, Christ, man, and woman. Read.
Every man.
Now he says, after he said that, he said, now every man.
Praying or prophesying.
If you're praying to God, if you're reading the Bible, you listen to the Bible.
Having his head covered.
Have your head covered if you have something over your head, like right now you got your hat on.
Dishonoreth his head.
What's the word to use?
Dishonoreth.
What does it mean to dishonor somebody? Disrespect. You show a lack of respect. So right here, the Bible is telling you every man that has his hat on, something covers his head while he's reading, listening to the scriptures, praying, it said he shows a lack of respect for God. Read it. Finish it off.
Dishonoreth his head.
So now let me ask you a question. You understand that scripture? Now what should you do if you know the scripture said having your head covered is dishonoring God? What are you supposed to do? So you going to take that off? Hey, all praise to the Most High. Too easy, right? Bro, too easy. See, that's repentance right there, bro. It's too easy to do that thing. Now go to Hosea 5:15. I'm going to show you something. Go ahead.
The book of Hosea, chapter 5, verse 15. I will go and return to my place till they acknowledge their offense.
So God is right here in Hosea 5:15 speaking to us, the Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans. He said he was going to go to his place, meaning turn his back on his people that he said was above all. The people he blessed, he said he's going to turn his back. Read.
And seek my face in their affliction.
Now what?
In their affliction. They will seek me early.
God said when we're being afflicted, that's when we're going to turn to God.
Right.
Because he knows his people. We are, bro, you already know how it is. You grew up in the same type of neighborhoods I grew up in. We are hard-headed people, are we not?
When you say afflicted, what that mean?
Afflicted. That's the chastening he's talking about. So, for instance, when it said, in his affliction, you you have, give me that, what's that in Job?
Job 36:15.
Give me that, Job 36:15. So an example of the affliction that we go through while we live paycheck to paycheck. That's called affliction. You got five kids, one dad helps out, and it's not even enough. You still can't afford anything. That's called affliction. In and out of jail, that's affliction.
Right.
You get caught with herpes, STDs, gonorrhea, AIDS, that's affliction.
Right.
You can't even find a job once you get out of jail. That's called affliction. Everything that's set up against us is our affliction that God is saying, I'm doing this to you until you say, I'm sorry.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Exactly. And that's what I'm going to show you. The reason God is doing this, the reason we're oppressed as a people, he put the answers and the solutions in the Bible. Watch this.
The book of Job, chapter 36, verse 15.
Go ahead.
He delivereth the poor in his affliction.
He does what?
Delivereth the poor in his affliction.
The poor is us. God said he delivers us in that poor.
Some of the homeless people who I know are so sweet.
Right.
They've been down there. You see
them? Uh-huh. But what happened? But now they're on the street. That's a part of our affliction. Read.
And openeth their ears in oppression.
He does what?
Openeth their ears in oppression.
God said he opens our ears in oppression. That's why since we got off the boats, the black man has been what? Oppressed in America. We felt good for one point during the time period with that Black Wall Street, but guess what? The white man came and dropped bombs on it.
Right.
And then now we are today. We assimilated with everybody else. Assimilation means, it doesn't mean the black man is at the top and the white man. Assimilation means black and Hispanics, you're at the bottom and every other nation is above you.
Right.
That's assimilation. What we're trying to teach our people is repent and keep God's commandments. Learn to work together by yourself first. Because in affliction, the Lord said we're going to seek his face. Meaning what? We're going to continue to be afflicted until we repent. Until that bomb drop and kill everybody on this place.
Right.
So you, if you say you got a mission, bro, your mission is to wake up and repent. I'm going to show you Psalm 94:16. I'm going to show you the reason the Most High God sent you here to ask you one question.
Now, wow.
I'm going to show you. Watch. I'm going to let God speak. I'm not even going to say my own words. I'm going to show you why God called you over here to listen to us.
The book of Psalms, chapter 94, verse 16. Who will rise up for me?
God is asking a question.
Against the evildoers. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
God said, who's going to stand up against the evildoers? Is that you? Yeah. So guess what you got to start doing, bro? You got to start. You got to fly, right? We got a school address on there. Our school is 15 minutes off the freeway, bro. That's why you came. All praise to the Most High. You start learning who you are. If I ask you what tribe you're from, you're going to tell me African-American or you're going to tell me something else? You're going to say African-American, but that's not what God calls you. You see what I'm saying? I'm going to show you that real quick. Deuteronomy 28:37. Go ahead.
This is the book.
Go, okay. All right, I'll be kind of quick with you, all right?
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 37. And thou shalt become an astonishment.
So when you read Deuteronomy 28:15, down is curses. 1-14 is blessing. God said, he was only speaking to Israel. He said, you're going to be cursed or you're going to be blessed. Which one do you take? So right here, this is one of the curses. Go ahead.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations.
So some of the curses he said will become an astonishment, a form of amazement to the other nations. That's why we march and protest for equal rights, but we're killing each other. That's an astonishment. We want to dress like the white woman, but then at the same time, we ain't got no affiliation with
her. Right.
We're destroyed as a nation of people. He said an astonishment. What's the other word?
A proverb.
A proverb.
A proverb is a wise saying. Black people like watermelon and chicken. If you want to hide something from a nigga, you put it in a book. All black people, no black man take care of his kids. That's a lie. But that's a wise saying that has a little bit of truth to it. You feel me? Go ahead.
And a byword.
And a byword. Byword. You call yourself African American. What does this song right here say? Where it says next to American blacks. Judah, right?
That's
so
right.
American black is what they called us. That's a byword. That's called out being called something outside of your race. Right here, Judah is what God calls you. The praise of God. That's you. Judah,
right.
Same tribe Jesus Christ came from, because Christ is a black man, and he had a flesh father. He came from the tribe of Judah. So when you understand who you are, you'll understand the power that's in your veins. That's the reason why they practice so much on this media to destroy our people. You have our young sisters out here bleaching their skin. You even got the brothers doing it. But our sisters doing what? Putting blonde weave in their hair. Putting colored contacts in their eyes. Why? Because we're destroyed as a nation of people. That's why they push so hard on our children. Our children first, bro. What's that thing called? World Star Hip Hop. You know about that, right? That's destroying our people. YouTube is to watch our people, and they put that stuff out there.
Hey, loud star here, bro.
Our people lost, but guess what? You heard the question God asked you earlier, right? Who's gonna stand up and rock, who's gonna stand up against the workers of iniquity? If you say that's what you wanna do, bro, you got our flyer, come learn, bro. So we can build you up, teach you some more, and guess what? You could be out here one day helping us out.
All right,
for sure, bro. Well, what's your name again?
Mario.
All right, y'all on, bro. You got our contact information on the back of that flyer, bro. All right, yes, sir.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.